This is Editor Bill Hernandez at rockbandreviews.com, and we're talking today with Mylo Anthony, who is the musical director and bass player for the Heart tribute band Pure Heart. Pure Heart is locally based here in Fort Lauderdale, and we'll be performing this Tuesday night at the iHeart radio station in Miramar for an unforgettable performance. Thank you for talking with us today, Mylo.
How you doing?
Ah, doing great, man, doing great. What about that rain last night, man?
Oh, wow. Yeah, well, it's the season, so you can expect it.
I know, right? Well, hey, man,
yeah.
We need it, that's for sure. Now, you're the musical director of the iHeart tribute band Pure Heart, and for those that are listening to this who are not familiar with the music business, what is the job of the musical director of a band?
Well, basically, my role as the director is, as well as being a player, is to coordinate everything from the stage plot to, directing the band during the time we're on stage, and also, some of the elements of running the band, from the financial end. So I basically cover all aspects of everything, including being a player. So, getting gigs and discussing that with whoever, we're playing for and that type of thing. So pretty much everything.
Yeah, you have your hands in everything because besides musical director, you're like manager, you're like a tour manager, a publicist as well. So
that's
good. Now, as a player, you do play bass guitar. What was it that drew you to the bass instrument in particular?
Well, when I was young, I was a real huge influence from all the arena rock bands, from Ambrosia to, Little River Band to many of the arena rock, of course, Journey, and then Enter Heart. As well, included there. And I grew up in an area, I grew up in Boulder, Colorado, which was a very interesting melting pot for underground music as well as mainline music. So the bass was an instrument that I was really drawn to after I saw Paul McCartney play, and then, of course, John Entwistle, and all my big musical influences as bass, and, of course, Sting, and then, some of the players that were singers as well as bassists. And so that's what drew me. I wasn't really much on the guitar, and I did learn piano, and I played drums as well, but that was really the instrument of choice, and that's what I pursued at a very young age. So up to this point, I've been playing it a long time.
Yeah, right. Now, you had mentioned at the beginning of your answer Ambrosia and Little River Band. Now, Little River Band is local. Singer Wayne Nelson lives right out of Boca, and
sure.
Ambrosia's here, it seems like, almost six times a year. Do you ever get together and kind of play with those guys or jam or anything?
Well, I do know Burleigh Drummond from the band, and of course, I know the bass player, and I've met them and, been with them in the past few years, all great guys. And I think the big influence to me was just, the type of music that they did, and it's all vocal music, so I'm more drawn to vocal and harmonies type music. That's the way it's always been for me. But yeah, they're all great guys. Of course, I grew up in Boulder. That's where Firefall was from. I still have friends there as well that associate with those guys. Mm-hmm. And Tommy Bolin was there as well. Uriah Heep. I go way back now, clear back in the 70s when I was a little kid, but I had a brother that was 10 years older than me, so all of my influences were 10 years in front of, my age.
Yeah, yeah.
So I was listening to Santana and Pink Floyd, old Pink Floyd, back in the day when I was a kid, and Ted Nugent, and, just all that kind of music that was my influence. But really what drew me was all of the bands that could really sing vocally, that they had like a full range of, vocal harmonies. I was a harmony lover.
Mm-hmm.
So, and that's what drew me to Heart. With the sisters, with the Wilson sisters, really their music is more than just rock music. It's harmonies, and it's just an amazing blend, of their voices plus rock. So that's what drew me to that.
Yeah, and there's nothing wrong with seeing two gorgeous women on stage, you know, singing and wielding guitars as well.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely.
Now, how did the idea to start a heart tribute band first come about? I mean, there's so many bands out there, and you just mentioned why, you know, heart is near and dear to you. But how did that come about?
Well, I was involved with other projects, of course, in the local area here in South Florida for many, many years, for decades. And the tribute started to come forward. Mm-hmm. And you know, I was talking with my keyboard player, and we had decided, wow, we want to try some, you know, some type of a tribute to someone big. Mm-hmm. And pretty much all the main tributes were already covered, like Journey and the Eagles and all those, you know, very big venue bands. And so we said, well, why don't we try, you know, a hard act and see if we can find the personnel to do it. And, you know, it took a couple of years, but we finally did arrive at a lineup, and that's how we decided. But heart has always been dear to me, because I remember the first time I ever heard Magic Man. I was, you know, very young and couldn't believe that that was someone singing, like a female singing that voice, you know. And
yeah,
and so I was always really drawn to all of their music. And then of course I reversed and went back clear back to their first, you know, albums like Dreamboat Annie and you know, Dog and Butterfly and all that, it clear up to, you know, 3 decades of music. So we wanted to put together a band that really played the radio hits of Heart. That was the main focus of coming forward with this band, not necessarily the B-side of music of Heart.
Yeah.
Or the off music. We wanted to play all of the radio rock hits of Heart.
Now, the newest band member to join Pure Heart is vocalist and guitarist Robin Fear, who plays the role of Nancy Wilson. I mean, how did you find her? I mean, it's one thing to be able, you know, I mean, you know, Nancy sings and all that, but we all know Ann is like the main vocalist. But I mean, to be able to sing Nancy's part, but the hard part, because I play guitar as well. I mean, just to play, you know, what Nancy plays. I mean, just to find a female that can actually come really, really close note for note for playing that. How did you come across Robin?
Well, we were hard pressed to find a Nancy. Anne was fairly easy to find because, of course, everyone wants to sing the Anne part, the lead part.
Mm-hmm.
And I had known about Robin for many years. As a matter of fact, I knew about Robin over 20 some years. But she was always involved in other projects. But then she came forward and said, hey, you know, I'd really like to try this project. And so, you know, we started rehearsing together and seeing what the chemistry was like. And wow, she's a great acoustic player and plays the role amazingly.
Yeah,
so we're very blessed to have her.
She even has the moves down with the kicks and everything, you know?
Yeah. And then she looks like her too, you know, acts like her. She's got the same mannerisms. So it's really cool.
And but, I mean, Robin Fear, I mean, isn't that like one of the greatest rock names?
I know. And it's her real name. I can't believe it. You know, it's not a stage name.
That's crazy.
Yeah. Now, so when we got her together with, you know, with our lead singer, who's our Ann Wilson, we call her Lexanne, her name's Alexis Mitchell, but with the two of them together in the front, we really have a great combination. You know, they work well together, and as you know, covering those parts are not easy, but they do a great job. So
now, it's a given that people who come out to see Pure Heart are going to hear all of, you know, Heart's, you know, greatest hits and such. Now, in Heart's live shows, they usually, you know, go out and throw some Led Zeppelin in their set. Can fans expect the same from Pure Heart?
Well, we have, over the couple of years we've been together playing out, we have decided, for now at least, just to cover one or two of their songs. Mm-hmm. I know that there's other bands that like to cover several of the Led Zeppelin songs, but we really wanted to keep this band emulated towards the radio rock hits of Heart, and then we usually close the show with a Led Zeppelin song.
Mm.
But so we don't really have a set of Led Zeppelin, so to speak.
Yeah.
But we do, you know, keep a song or two in the mix because we knew they were so highly influenced by Led Zeppelin.
Yep.
So.
finally, how can people go about getting tickets for this Tuesday night's Pure Heart show at the iHeart radio station?
Well, that was on a local radio station here that they were given tickets over the radio.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe that's how they were doing this particular event. So that's how it was happening for the Tuesday night tribute.
Okay, so so for those that want to go to your website and see what upcoming local gigs you have, what is the website address?
The website address is pureheartribute.com.
Okay.
And it's a full page. You can go on and scroll through and, you know, see everything that we, where we've been and who we are and, of course, our tour date.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, you can see the band and it's a full site.
Like one or two shows coming up in the future, where are those at?
Well, we're talking about right now the band shell in Daytona, which is a great show for us to do. We have not done it yet, but we've been selected to possibly do that. And we do a lot of West Coast work as well here in South Florida, over in Fort Myers and up to Tampa Bay. So mainly, you know, venues like concert hall venues is where we work. And of course, locally here, we do a lot of events. So that's what we have coming up.
Speaking of concert halls and venues and such, have you played the PGA Arts Center yet?
We have been asked to play the PGA Arts Center recently, and we will be booking a date there at some point, and I'm not sure whether it's going to be June, July, or August.
Mm-hmm.
But they had contacted us about booking a date there, and we're excited about it because we think it's a great venue.
Yeah, and it seems that they're hosting a ton of tribute bands, you know, like The Long Run and Chain Reaction.
Sure.
And Majesty of Rock and stuff like that. So that's becoming known as a venue to go see really the best, you know, tribute bands in the country, and we hope to see you there real soon.
Yeah, we're looking forward to it, of course. Absolutely.
Wonderful, wonderful.